game. I'm Roselle Rasay from the Caucus of Development NGO Networks Philippines. I guess the biggest problem in terms of democracy in the Philippines is that the president himself is trying to set up authoritarian government and trying to undermine democratic institutions. The president has the support of the entire Congress that questions the role of the Supreme Court, the role of the Senate, has incarcerated a senator, and everyone who have dissented, who have dissenting opinion to the president's directive. So, just recently, there were news and the president himself has been repeating himself that he wanted to declare a revolutionary government, mainly to address the problems in society, crime, address corruption. But actually, we thought that declaring a revolutionary government will only further establish authoritarianism and dictatorship. There were words actually a week ago that people, we've heard of mobilizations that will happen where people will clamor for the president to call for to declare a revolutionary government. But actually, we thought that it is organized by the government itself. And so many civil society organizations organized a No to RevCo campaign just before the planned declaration. And true enough, there were no public support for a revolutionary government. Very few people came out of the streets supposedly supporting RevCo. We just thought that these are ways the president was testing the waters and trying to push boundaries, checking the waters if he could establish authoritarianism. But it turns out that it has no public support, and that civil society organizations continue to call for transparency, accountability, good governance, and protection of human rights.